The most frequent reference to Jesus' resurrection reveals that he rose from the grave on the third day of his entombment. Matthew, Mark, and Luke all record Jesus as prophesying that he would rise from the grave on this day, the third day. What's more, while preaching to Cornelius and his household, Peter indicated that God raised Jesus up on the third day. The fact is, however, Jesus also taught that he would be killed and after 3 days rise again. Furthermore, Jesus elsewhere prophesied that he would be in the heart of the earth for 3 days and 3 nights. So which is it? Did Jesus rise from the dead on the third day or after 3 days? To the 21st century reader, these statements may initially appear to contradict one another. But in reality, they harmonize perfectly if one understands the different and sometimes more flexible methods ancients used when reckoning time. In Bible times, any part of a day could be computed for the whole day and the night following it. As awkward as it may sound to an American living in the 21st century, a person in ancient times could legitimately speak of something occurring on the third day after 3 days or after 3 days and 3 nights, yet still be referring to the same exact day. Consider two biblical examples, one from the Old Testament and one from the New. 2 Chronicles 10 clearly testifies that the ancients, at least occasionally, considered a portion of a 24-hour period as the whole of it. Prior to the divided kingdom, when Israel asked King Rehoboam to lighten their burdens, he wanted time to contemplate their request, so he instructed Jeroboam and the people of Israel to return after 3 days. Interestingly, verse 12 of that chapter indicates that Jeroboam and the people of Israel came to Rehoboam on the third day, as the king had directed, saying, "Come back to me the third day." Fascinating, is it not, that even though Rehoboam had instructed his people to return after 3 days, they understood this to mean on the third day. Consider also Acts chapter 10, verse 3, in which we learn how an angel appeared to Cornelius at about the ninth hour of the day, about 3 p.m. Verse 9 says that the next day, Peter received a vision from God and welcomed visitors sent by Cornelius. Then, on the next day, verse 23, Peter and the servants of Cornelius departed for Caesarea. And the following day, verse 24, they entered Caesarea where Peter taught Cornelius and his household the gospel. At one point during Peter's visit, Cornelius spoke about his encounter with the angel of God. Notice carefully how he began the rehearsal of the event in verse 30. He said, "4 days ago to this hour, I was praying in my house during the ninth hour." Although the event actually had occurred only 72 hours earlier, or 3 literal days, Cornelius spoke of it as taking place 4 days ago to this very hour. Why 4 days instead of 3? Because according to their method of reckoning time, a part of the first day and a part of the fourth day could be counted as whole days. Surely one can see how this information aligns itself perfectly with Jesus' burial and resurrection. If he was buried on Friday and his resurrection occurred on Sunday, this event could truthfully be described as a 3-day burial, not 1 or 2. Even though some today may find this reasoning somewhat confusing, comparable calculations are often used today. For example, consider the guest at a hotel who checks in at 8 p.m. on Wednesday and checks out at 7 p.m. on Thursday, less than 24 hours later. Did the man stay 1 or 2 days at the hotel? Technically, the guest was there for less than 1 full day, less than 24 hours, yet the hotel legally can charge him for 2 days since he did not leave before the mandatory 11 a.m. checkout. Considering how flexible we are in measuring time, depending on the context, perhaps we should not be surprised at how flexible the ancients could be in calculating time. Further evidence proving that Jesus' statements regarding his burial were not contradictory centers around the fact that even his enemies did not accuse him of contradicting himself. No doubt this was due to their understanding of the flexible, customary method of stating time in their day. The chief priests and Pharisees said to Pilate the day after Jesus was crucified, "Sir, we remember while he was still alive how that deceiver said, 'After 3 days I will rise.' Therefore, command that the tomb be made secure until the third day." The phrase "after 3 days" must have been equivalent to "the third day" or else the enemies would have asked for the guard of soldiers until the fourth day. Interesting, is it not, that modern skeptics charge Jesus with contradicting himself, but not the adversaries of his own day? The expressions that Jesus and the Bible writers use to describe how long Jesus would remain in the grave do not necessarily mean that he was buried for a literal 72 hours. If we interpret the account of Jesus' burial and resurrection in light of the cultural setting of the first century, we find no errors in any of the expressions that Jesus and the gospel writers used.